If you could travel from city to city within just minutes, would you do it? What if I told you about a form of transportation that's been conceptualized to do exactly that? Welcome to Modern Day Geeks, and today we're going to talk about the Hyperloop. In 2013, Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla and SpaceX, came up with an idea of a super-fast train that would travel through a vacuum tube. It would be called
the Hyperloop.
The Hyperloop?
Hyperloop, yeah.
The aim of the Hyperloop is to be the fastest way to travel through cities by slashing long travel times from hours to just minutes. And Elon Musk has described it as the fifth mode of transportation after planes, trains, boats, and automobiles. It's fast. The Hyperloop is envisioned to reach speeds of over 500 miles per hour and can take passengers from San Francisco to LA in only 30 minutes. In contrast, a bullet train reaches approximately 150 miles per hour and can take people between LA and Las Vegas in 80 minutes. In short, that's really, really fast. It uses renewable energy. The Hyperloop offers low-energy, long-distance travel, running on electricity and solar energy. It achieves this by requiring very little energy to propel pods through its vacuum tube, resulting in lower carbon emissions. It's also less invasive. Hyperloops can be built on columns or underground, reducing the risk of collisions with people or other vehicles. Leading companies in the development of the Hyperloop: Virgin Hyperloop and Hyperloop TT. From the name of Hyperloop One in 2014, the company was rebranded following a significant investment from Sir Richard Branson in 2017. Virgin Hyperloop uses magnetic levitation, or maglev. This isn't an entirely new concept, as we'll talk about later. Virgin Hyperloop has conducted a test back in 2017, where they built a 500-meter track in the Nevada desert. They then carried out several tests in May 2017. The propulsion, braking, levitation, and vacuum systems performed well, and it attained a top speed of 240 miles per hour. On November 8, 2020, the first two passengers traveled safely in the two-seater experimental pod 2, or XP2, where they went 48 meters per second, or about 107 miles per hour. On the other hand, is an American company known as Hyperloop TT, or Hyperloop Transportation Technologies. They were founded in 2013 and have been making aggressive advancements, along with having recently constructed a full-scale test track in France. Alternatives to Hyperloop: maglev and bullet trains. The Shanghai Maglev Train. As mentioned before, Virgin Hyperloop's technology will use maglev, or magnetic levitation, for their Hyperloop. It works by propelling trains using two sets of magnets, one to lift and push the train above the track, and another to move it forward. The maglev concept is not new. In fact, there are already a few trains in the world that use it. One of those being the Shanghai Maglev train that was launched in China way back in 2003. The Shanghai Maglev train is the first commercial maglev line in the world. With an average speed of 143 miles per hour, and with a commercial max speed of 268 miles per hour, the 19-mile journey between Longyang Road Station to Pudong International Airport only takes no more than 8 minutes to complete. Japan's high-speed trains are called Shinkansen, which translates to New Main Line. One of the fastest trains in the world, the trains on their network can run upwards of 187 miles per hour. For reference, a 212-mile trip from Tokyo to Nagoya takes just an hour and a half. It's widely used in Japan, and as of now, it's still being innovated and expanded on. Of course, attempts at paving the way forward are never going to go smoothly. The Hyperloop already faces quite a few problems, the first being cost. Several factors could come into play when calculating the cost of developing a Hyperloop system, but one thing's for sure, it's not going to be cheap. Virgin Hyperloop estimates that a route from LA to San Francisco could cost upwards of $84 million to $121 million per mile. Next up, safety. Compared to regular railway systems which run out in the open, Hyperloop pods will be situated within sealed vacuum tubes. This poses a huge problem. In the event that any weather phenomenon or natural disaster damages the tubes, the sudden influx of air could cause explosive decompression. To add to that, passengers won't have long to escape both the pod and the fortified steel tube. And lastly, capacity. The maximum capacity of the Hyperloop per pod is 28 passengers, which means that there will be 1,120 passengers per hour. The number of passengers per hour are inferior compared to trains such as Shinkansen and 700A, which can take up to 1,323 passengers per train, and they have 13 trains, which means that Shinkansen can carry 17,199 people per hour. With all of these factors combined, the Hyperloop has a long way to go before it can be widely adapted for cities around the world. Overall, it is possible to have a commercial Hyperloop in the future, but the speed of it might be lower than the ideal top speed of 760 miles per hour. The concept also faces quite a few issues. Along with the advancements being made with bullet trains, there's also the problem of the costs of developing a Hyperloop system and the general infancy of the whole idea. As a result, it's difficult to see this being widely adopted anytime soon. Technology advances rather quickly, however, and massive changes could be made in less than a decade. Whatever the case, be it rail vehicles or the Hyperloop taking the lead, what's clear is that we're nearing a future where cities are brought within just minutes, if not seconds, of each other. Did you enjoy the video? Leave a like and subscribe if you did. Let us know your thoughts about the video and the Hyperloop system in general.